Friends, in this webinar, we shall discuss the management of jaundice in preterm neonates. The management of neonatal jaundice in preterm infants is unclear. Most recommendations for treatment in this population are essentially consensus-based rather than evidence-based. This slide summarizes the recommendations by the National Neonatology Forum for the TSB, that is the total serum bilirubin thresholds at or above which treatment is recommended. The second and third column show the TSB thresholds for starting phototherapy in a healthy and sick preterm newborn respectively. The last column shows the TSB thresholds for exchange transfusion. The following neonates are considered to be sick. 1. Neonates with rapidly rising TSB levels, which is taken as greater than 0.5 milligrams per deciliter per hour, suggesting hemolysis, and 2. Neonates with clinical instability or sepsis or asphyxia. Let us take an example. A neonate with birth weight of 1100 grams with septic shock and metabolic acidosis has a bilirubin value of 7 milligrams per deciliter. This neonate would be labeled as sick, and thereby the neonate would require phototherapy at this level of serum bilirubin. Now, let us consider a stable preterm neonate with birth weight of 2200 grams with a bilirubin value of 10.5 milligrams per deciliter. This neonate will not require phototherapy. Neonates with any of the following conditions in the previous 24 hours are considered to have clinical instability: apnea requiring bag and mask ventilation, hypotension requiring pressors, and mechanical ventilation at the time of blood sampling. While deciding the need for treatment, it is important to remember that one should use total serum bilirubin. There is no need to subtract direct fraction of bilirubin unless it is more than 50% of the total. We recommend the use of the lower value of the range presented in the table in neonates of lower birth weight or gestational age. Exchange transfusion is recommended if the TSB levels are above the birth weight specific thresholds for exchange, or if the neonate shows signs of suspected acute bilirubin encephalopathy irrespective of the bilirubin value. Remember that recommendations for exchange transfusion in hospitalized neonates apply to those receiving intensive double surface phototherapy to the maximal surface area, but whose TSB levels continue to increase despite intensive phototherapy. For readmitted infants, if the TSB level is above the exchange threshold, intensive phototherapy should be started pending arrangement for exchange transfusion. One may consider a repeat TSB measurement just prior to the procedure to confirm the TSB levels are still above the exchange level. Please note that the classical signs of acute bilirubin encephalopathy, such as hypertonia, arching, retrocolis, opisthotonus, high pitched cry, and fever, may not be present in preterm neonates. The only signs of acute bilirubin encephalopathy in preterm neonates may be nonspecific, such as poor feeding, reduced tone, and recurrent apneas. While the neonate is receiving phototherapy, there is no role for clinical assessment or transcutaneous bilirubin levels. In general, TSB can be repeated every 12 to 24 hours. As opposed to this, a baby with a setting for hemolysis, such as RH or ABO isoimmunization, would require TSB measurements more frequently, every 6 to 8 hours during the initial 24 to 48 hours or so. Discontinue phototherapy when TSB is 2 mg per deciliter below the initiation level. Thank you.